why it's even important to get your dog trained. Preston Van Loon and Rocky are here to explain the benefits of training. Thanks so much for coming up and visiting us again.
Thank you. Good to be here.
It's always nice to have you and Rocky here. You guys always bring lots of smiles with you. So we're talking about the benefits of dog training. And like we kind of said, we've been working on different things throughout the year. But why is training your dog so important?
Because you care about your dog. Mm-hmm. It's about being a responsible dog owner and doing the right thing for your dog. You know, you spend a lot of time, a lot of money on your dog. You want to have a positive relationship with your dog. So training is very much worthwhile, and it pays benefits for the years that you have your dog. Many people find a sense of security and comfort knowing that their dog is trained, or they get to know their dog better by learning how to communicate with it.
Mm-hmm, very interesting. So what do you think is the greatest benefit, in your opinion, of having a trained dog?
You know, there are so many wonderful benefits from training your dog. Anywhere from having a dog that is well-behaved, that gets along with people, that tolerates distractions.
Yeah, Wayne.
but I think the greatest benefit, you know, is the bond that you build with your dog. Mm-hmm. As you work with your dog and invest energy and time into your dog, you're building a relationship, and that bond becomes stronger as you spend time in training together.
Mm-hmm. Very interesting. So what about for the dog? What is the training benefit for dogs? They must benefit from it.
Dogs benefit tremendously. Studies have been shown that when a dog is trained as a puppy, it is psychologically healthier as an adult. Mm. Also, it's been proven that dogs that receive training are more likely to stay with their forever home for the rest of their life. Some other benefits might be the dog has confidence. They have better impulse control and discipline. Mm-hmm. They're less fearful. And they're more comfortable being around other people. They're socialized more, mm-hmm. and so they like being around people.
Absolutely. So it's probably more work on the front end when these puppies are young and they have tons of energy. It's hard to train them, but if they're staying with people, if the statistics are that they'll stay in that home longer because the owner's not getting frustrated that they're not listening and they're still chewing up shoes or doing whatever they're going to do, then it might be more work on the front end, but the rest of it is going to be more smooth.
That's right. I think you need to look at training really as a lifelong process, mm-hmm. much like humans that go to school and they're continuously learning. Mm-hmm. You just don't begin training and then stop, but you continue to train your dog throughout life. Rocky's received a lot of training throughout his life, and I continue to challenge him, mm-hmm. to help him to grow and to learn. And what it does is it just strengthens our bond.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So there's that bond, that strengthened bond that you have with your dog. What other benefits do dog owners get from having a trained dog?
Yep. Well, they get a dog that is well-behaved and knows how to function in a human world. That's really key, I think, because we're taking a dog that historically, many thousands of years back, mm-hmm. was a wild animal, and we're teaching it how to function in our world. And so we build a better relationship with the dog. We have a dog that has good manners, knows how to get along with people, a dog that will receive visitors when they come to your house, a dog that you can take a walk with and get along with, just a dog that behaves appropriately, not only in the home, but with other people and in society as a whole. So the dog is much more well-behaved and accepted by many people.
Absolutely. They're always more welcome to come around when you can kind of predict their behavior. You know that there's someone that's going to be able to step in if
needed.
If
Rocky wasn't trained, he mm-hmm. would have a hard time right now. He would be going crazy in this room here. He'd be running all over, and he'd be running up to things, smelling things, mm-hmm. and he's smelling the carpet right now,
yep.
because he knows other dogs have been in here. But he's behaving,
yeah.
you know, so that's a good thing.
Yeah, absolutely. So we have about 30 seconds left. Maybe go over some of the consequences or, you know, that happen when you don't have a trained dog.
Yep. Poor socialization. Mm-hmm. You'll have behavioral problems with chewing and barking and things like that. Mm-hmm. You might have security issues where other people risk being hurt by the dog. Mm-hmm. You have a difficult time building that relationship, so the relationship could be strained. Mm-hmm. And the dog would have poor socialization. The dog would not know how to get along and work with other people.
Yeah, so it'd be more stressful for you as the owner and more stressful for the dog as the pet.
Believe me, it costs a lot more to have a dog that's not trained than to invest in training a dog.
That is so true. That's good, solid advice, I think, to leave with Preston. Thank you so much for bringing in Rocky today. He always brings lots of smiles.
Yeah, we love it. It's good to be here. Rocky's happy. I'm happy.
Excellent. Well, everybody's happy then. Thank you so much for coming in, Preston.
Thank you.